The Secret Lives of Giant Pandas. Hey there, friends. Today, we're diving into the world of one of the most adorable animals on the planet, giant pandas. You might think you know these black and white cuties, but trust me, they've got some surprises up their sleeves. Or should I say, fur? Let's explore these fascinating animals together and uncover the secrets of their lives. So, here's something interesting. Pandas are technically classified as carnivores, but do they follow the rules? Spoiler alert, they don't. These fluffy guys are all about that bamboo life. They munch on it almost exclusively, making up about 99% of their diet. And get this, an adult panda chows down on 26 to 84 pounds of bamboo a day. That's like a massive salad buffet every single day. Why so much? Well, bamboo isn't exactly packed with nutrients, so they've got to eat a ton to get enough energy. Occasionally, they might snack on a bit of meat or find a tasty morsel in the wild, but that's pretty rare. All right, so where are these panda parties happening? You'll find them chilling in the mountainous regions of central China, specifically in places like Sichuan, Shaanxi, and Gansu provinces. These spots are filled with temperate forests and, you guessed it, tons of bamboo. They live at elevations between 5,000 and 10,000 feet, where it's cool and moist, perfect for bamboo to thrive. And let's talk about their iconic black and white look. Not just a fashion statement, folks. This coloration helps them blend into their misty, shadowy forest environment, which keeps them safe. Plus, they're just naturally dressed for a fancy black tie event all the time. Now, if there's one thing pandas are famous for besides bamboo, it's their tricky love lives. The breeding season happens only once a year, typically in spring, from March to May. And guess what? The females are only in the mood for 2 to 3 days per year. Talk about a tight schedule. After a successful meetup, which is no small feat, the mama panda enters a gestation period lasting anywhere from 95 to 160 days. Usually, only one little panda cub makes it, which is why every newborn is such a big deal in the panda world. Pandas are the ultimate introverts. They like their space and are generally solitary, except, of course, during that brief relationship window we just talked about. They communicate in their own special way, not with texts or calls, but through vocal sounds and scent markings. Each sound and scent says something different, letting other pandas know important info without needing to meet face to face. Now on to some brighter news. Thanks to extensive conservation efforts, pandas are no longer classified as endangered, though they are still vulnerable. Efforts to expand protected habitats and breeding programs have been successful, leading to a gradual rise in panda populations. It's an ongoing process and one that shows the positive impact of wildlife preservation. So there you have it, giant pandas, the bamboo-munching, solo-loving conservation icon of the animal kingdom. They're not just symbols of cuteness, but also of why it's crucial to protect and preserve our planet's wildlife. Every small action counts. If you loved this panda talk, make sure to hit that like button, drop a comment if you've got a fun panda fact, and subscribe for more wild adventures. Also, check out the links below for more on how you can help in conservation efforts. Thanks for hanging out with me today. Until next time, keep exploring and caring for our amazing planet.